Hi, I'm Sarah. Welcome to the Daily English Show. Today's mistake comes from a sign I saw at a music festival. The sign says, Northern Base recommends you wear suitable footwear at all times to ensure you don't get splinters. Can you see anything wrong with that sign? Splinters shouldn't have a capital S. A splinter is a small, thin piece of wood, glass, or other similar material broken off from a larger piece. On that sign, there's no reason why splinters should be capitalized. How about Northern Base? Is that okay with capital letters? Yes, because that's the name of the event. In English, we use capital letters for names of places, books, brands, people's names, but not for regular nouns, unless they're at the start of a sentence. So let's say I said this. I watched The Godfather with David, and then we drove to Walmart in my Maserati. The Godfather is the name of a movie, so that should be capitalized. David is a person's name, and Maserati and Walmart are both brand names, so they should all be capitalized. But if I said, I watched a movie with a friend, and then we drove to the supermarket in my car, then the only thing capitalized in that sentence would be the I, because it's at the start of the sentence, and also because the personal pronoun I is always capitalized. The site I'd like to talk about today is called the Clickbait Headline Generator. This is a humorous site that makes random clickbait headlines. So, what are clickbait headlines? Well, before the internet, when we read news on paper, writers always tried to capture the attention of the reader with catchy headlines. And the purpose was to get the reader to read that article, or if the article was on the front page, maybe to buy the paper. But with clickbait headlines, they don't care so much if you read the article. The point is they want you to click on the article so that they can get traffic to sell advertising and make money. And clickbait headlines have a certain structure that they usually follow, which is how they could make this generator. I made up some headlines to show you a few patterns that are used in clickbait. Firstly, clickbait headlines often use numbers. 7 surprising facts about learning English. 9 reasons why The Daily English Show is the greatest show ever. Clickbait headlines often use words like unbelievable, inspiring, or shocking. The unbelievable story of a man who became a fluent English speaker in just 3 days. This woman was asked to leave her English class. The reason why will shock you. Often clickbait headlines will be a question. Can you be a fluent English speaker by studying for just 10 seconds a day? How often do you get sucked in by clickbait? Did you feel like clicking on those headlines that I made up? How about this video, if you only clicked on it because of the title? How annoyed are you right now that you got sucked in? Kia ora in Stick News today, a man in the United States was angry with his local television station when he thought they changed their logo to support gay pride. Last week, same-sex marriage was legalized in the United States. Lots of people and brands celebrated by making their profile pictures rainbow-colored. The rainbow flag was designed by an artist in San Francisco in 1978 and is a symbol of gay pride. One man thought his local TV station had also changed its logo to a rainbow theme to celebrate gay pride, so he complained to the station. The TV station hadn't actually changed their logo. They're an affiliate of NBC, and they use the NBC peacock in their logo. And that was Stick News for Wednesday, the 1st of July. Kia ora. Today's word is ensure. The sign I showed you at the start of the show says, Northern Base recommends you wear suitable footwear at all times to ensure you don't get splinters. Ensure is a more formal way of saying make sure. So you're more likely to come across it in written English rather than spoken English. If you were renting or hiring some kind of room for your community group, the written instructions might say, please ensure all lights are off before you leave. But if you were reminding someone verbally about those instructions, you might say, make sure you turn all the lights off before you leave. I got one in my foot once. Just walking around outside, it was a tiny piece of wood. Baking soda. Yeah, I soaked it in some warm water and baking soda, and it came out quite easily. I don't remember ever getting splinters in my feet. I've got them in my fingers before, but not my feet. How? How did you get it out? Really? Baking soda? Oh, interesting. I've only ever used needles to get them out, but that sounds much better. Which is correct, A or B? Have you read Harry Potter? A. I talked to Tom yesterday. A. Do you want to watch a movie? B. We've run out of toothpaste. B. I want to visit New York. A. And that was The Daily English Show. I hope you enjoyed today's show. If you'd like to support the show, one thing you can do for us is, if you're planning to buy something from Amazon.com, you can go to our site first, thedailyenglishshow.com/support, and click on the Amazon banner, and then go to Amazon and buy whatever you're planning to buy. It won't cost you anything extra, but Amazon will give us a couple of dollars for sending you there. So if you're planning to buy something from Amazon, if you could go via our site, we'd really appreciate it. See you tomorrow. Bye.